Russia has confirmed that IT plans on building a new super aircraft carrier despite cuts in the defense budget. Yes, the Navy will build an aircraft carrier, for sure, wisatn Viktor Bozuk, the deputy commander-in-chief of Russia's Navy, said last month. ACC according to Russian state media different were aus are hammering out an image of this ship, he asked. The new aircraft carrier Bozuk was referring to is the so-called Project CT-23000ESHTOM. The proposed carrier will be powered by two written 200 nuclear engines and displace 100,000 tons. This is near lightweight by KTOF, Russia's only existing aircraft carrier. The Admiral Kuznetsov. Ich is steam powered and currently bein refit and modernized the Project CT-23000ESHTOM ship will also reportedly be able to carry Ninety aircraft Moscow's current carrier only has abutierti. Plan is on board. Beyond this plug in 100,000 tons, the SHTOM will also stretch 330 meters in length and 40 meters with a crew of 4000 sailors will man the vessel. Ich is expected to feature MiG-29K fighter jets, a naval version of the T-50 and a slew of different helicopters, ACC according to global security. The plan is for the ship to have two ramps and two electromagnetic catapults to launch aircraft from its deck to defend itself from aerial attacks. The aircraft carrier has air defense missile and anti-torpedo defense systems. Altau Karus in offizielles Klim hat a nuclear powered aircraft carrier has been under consideration since 2007. Russia's Krylov State Research Center first announced Project CT-23000ESHTOM in 2015. The first reports indicated it would be a conventionally powered vessel. The price tag for the SHTOM carriers has been placed at above 9 billion. Altau Kaorte Estimates Are Mukhaya Deputy Defense Minister Yuri Borisov has said that the contract for the ship will be signed around 2025 and the first vessel completed by 2030. There are good reasons to dubitate that Russia will actually build a nuclear-powered aircraft carrier in the foreseeable future for wanting. IT is far from clear that Russia's shipbuilding industry is up to the challenge as IHS Janis noted shortly after the SHTOM carrier was announced in 2015. The new vessels would be a quantum leap in capability and sits over the Russian Navy's single existing carrier, Admiral Kuznetsov. Complicating the problems for Moscow is the fact that the Soviet Union's aircraft carriers were all produced in Ukraine. Fakt already du mit an IKTI 5000 ton KR Kalet Ulyanovsk. Ich was beim Bild at the time the Soviet Union collapsed the order, KR under construction at that time was sold to China and later commissioned by the People's Liberation Army Navy under the name Liaoning. The new KR would also feature new capabilities that even the Soviet Union never mastered. Well, had the Ukrainian shipbuilding yards under its control most notably. Soviet carriers never feature nuclear-powered propulsion systems. Russian defense industry sources have told state media that I would gain expertise for this future KR system by first building a nuclear-powered destroyer at first. The nuclear power unit for the future national aircraft carrier will be worked out on. The leader destroyer, an unnamed shipbuilding industry source told us in 2015, but the leader destroyer program has encountered numerous deals and the first vessel is not slated to be completed until 2025 at the earliest. 6 years after IT was initially expected construction on the destroyers is not scheduled to begin until 2019, the two electromagnetic catapults would also be a huge leap from the sheer ramp configurations used on pre-VI aus Soviet and Russian carriers.